Television viewers in Denmark are tuning in tonight for the season two premiere of a surprise hit reality show. Its star is the U.S. ambassador to Copenhagen, Rufus Gifford, who was given the job by President Obama as a reward for raising more than $1 billion during the last election campaign. Ambassador Gifford, who is gay, married his partner in Denmark last weekend, and as special correspondent Malcolm Brabant reports, from Copenhagen, his unique brand of diplomacy is raising eyebrows amongst traditionalists.
In a city accustomed to flamboyance, the union of the U.S. ambassador to veterinarian Stephen De Vincent was not only the wedding of the year, but also a landmark for diplomacy, Rufus Gifford style.
Here in the country that created fairy tales, we get to have our fairy tale. And now I guess it's about happily ever after or something, right? But yes. Americans yes. are pretty good at that.
Yeah.
So we're just so happy.
The couple's cheerleader in chief is the ambassador's father, Chad, former chairman of the Bank of America.
Rufus is just such a people person. He has this unique ability, and there's nothing false about it, that he just cares. He cares about people, and that smile says it all. So he is so genuine, it amazes me.
How do you think the style helps America?
As an American, I worry about our country and our politicians that seem to say what they think they need to say to get elected. And I abhor that. I think it's sad for our country, and Rufus is the opposite of that. He says what he thinks, and he just believes what he says, and I wish we had more like him.
Within an hour of tying the knot, the ambassador was posting on social media where he has a huge following.
So, this is as far as you can come today, but on October 16th, please join us for the premiere of Yaya Ambassador for America, Season 2, on DR3. See you then.
My time in Denmark is running out.
I have the best job in the world.
This is just your average Wednesday.
But I have just over a year left in Denmark, and I want to spend every minute of my time here engaging as many Danes as I possibly can.
Great.
TV executive Erik Struve Hansen recognized the ambassador's box office potential and is responsible for creating a show that has wowed viewers of the country's main youth channel.
I think it has become that big a success because of Rufus' character. He is what we call a big character. All our viewers and a lot of people in Denmark, they love him, they think he's a good role model, he's so positive, and he likes Denmark as well. He's very positive about our country.
Weird if you did.
For Ambassador Gifford, it was a huge relief when, in June, the Supreme Court ruled that gay marriage was a constitutional right, a quarter of a century after Denmark led the way.
You're the first country in the world to recognize, you know, same-sex unions, so the idea that we're doing it here, it's a tribute to that as well.
Holy crow.
Yeah, that's hail to the chief. That's given me a pretty big promotion.
I'm not talking about you.
I think a very good ambassador as he is, so open and so warm, of course give the Danes a good impression of America.
I don't know if this is a diplomatic thing today or not. I mean, do I think that we've had let me say it this way, actually. We as the United States on these issues have come so, so far over the course of the last 10 years.
I love you with all my heart, Stephen John Vincent, and thank you for entrusting your heart and your happiness to me. It is the greatest honor.
Today, I think we tip our hat to Denmark and the journey that you've been on here for so many years. But also, I think this is, tonight, we are celebrating, partying late into the night with all of our friends and family under the American flag. And I am so grateful for the journey I think our country has gone on these issues. So perhaps there's a little bit of diplomacy there too. And what I say all the time is diplomacy is about people.
The British wartime Prime Minister Winston Churchill once described diplomacy as telling somebody to go to hell in such a way that they would ask for directions. Harry S. Truman, the former American president, said that tact was the ability to stand on a man's toes without messing up the shine on his shoes. The reality is that in Denmark, foreign relations are a walk in the park. It doesn't present the challenges of Russia or China. But the ambassador, a former Hollywood producer, has not managed to win over foreign policy expert Hans Mouritsen, a traditionalist when it comes to diplomacy. Don't you think that he's perhaps got some lessons to teach traditional diplomats, in that he seems to be doing an awful lot to be able to promote America's image?
Yeah, but the thing is, I think that he's promoting his own image, because I think people can understand that it's more his own image than the American image. Because people know all kinds of things about US foreign policy, which they don't like, but they like Mr. Gifford.
Do you not think that this might work in some other parts of the world, for example, where perhaps you need to have a different, fresh approach?
No, it wouldn't work in Eastern Europe because they don't like gay people. So it has to be in Western Europe. And that's about it. It couldn't be in Africa either. You have to have a very common cultural background, because to understand many of the things he says, you have to have this Anglo-American background, which we have in Scandinavia. So it works very well here.
At his residence, the ambassador disagrees.
I think you could do this in any country around the world. Is it easier in Denmark? Absolutely. If you go to other countries, which certainly might not be as receptive to American messaging, generally speaking, and the American brand is far worse than it is in Denmark, I think the work is going to be much harder. I think openness and honesty always win out in the end. And will you get hit in the meantime? Sure. Will it be hard in the meantime? Absolutely. But it's still worth it, because I think people respect it.
Love you guys. We'll see you in a couple of minutes. Yeah.
Rufus Gifford has worked for President Obama for almost 9 years, and diplomatic sources say he enjoys the trust of the White House. The big question is whether he'll seek political office once his term ends in a year's time. His father hopes not. He says the ambassador is too good for that. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Copenhagen.